So what are the basis for regression? We start with a topic called correlation. Okay, let me introduce correlation, and then if you look at what we have studied so far, z-test, we were comparing only single variable, sample and population. Then we did chi-square test, where you checked variance of the sample versus various population, or variance of sample versus in different examples. What was the problem we dealt with descriptive or inferential statistics is like, we have so far analyzed only a single random variable. If you take height, height. If you take weight, weight. Weight in sample, weight in population. Likewise, we never went and correlated two variables, two random variables, except in only one place in chi-square test, that too in the last class, dependence of variable, where we checked health and diet, compared both of the numbers. Except that place, everywhere we were talking about one variable only. In fact, I can go and say it is univariate analysis. What univariate techniques, let's say. Take one column. If you take sample or population, it's that one column. But machine learning statistical modeling revolves completely around relation between two variables and multiple variables. This, right? So how do we get into relation between two variables? Whatever we have studied, each variable in detail, now it will help when we start defining the relation between two variables. Okay, a sample example, classic example. Do men marry women of same age? Some example which I wanted to correlate with, or I wanted to establish a relationship between men's ages and women's ages. Of course, when they're marrying or after they married. Essentially, these are couples, like ages of couple. Couple 1, couple 2, couple 3, couple 4, couple 5. Like sample of husband and wife ages. Like in most of the cases, husband is elder to wife. In a very few cases, both have same age. And in very, very few cases, a husband has more age. Sorry, wife has more age than husband. Am I correct? Is that the insight? Yeah. Men are elder mostly. In a few cases, husband and wife have same age, right? In a very few cases, like at least this case, this one, probably wife has more age than husband. That's the insight. Okay. Now, instead of showing the previous sample, if I showed you this, will you be able to figure out the same insight? Will you be able to figure out the same insight? Let's say I showed you only this. The mean ages of husband is 49, standard deviation is 11. Mean age of all the wives is 47 and the standard deviation is 11. Ankit. Yep. Ankit tries to say that the differences has a limit. I mean, the differences belong to a very small interval. That's what Abdul was also trying to say. Hey, if we calculate differences, we'll get to know. Fine. Good. Interesting. Yeah, not the same insight from the cross tab, of course. Right. So this is called sample. What do you say? Sample stats. Sorry. Summary stats. the summary stats will lose the meaning. Because here, you cannot tell a husband age is greater than wife, or wife age is greater than husband, or at least you cannot strongly conclude that there are a few cases where wife's age is elder than wife is elder than husband. You can't strongly conclude. All you can conclude here is like, on an average, husbands are elder than their wives. On an average. Now look at this scatter plot. Now tell me what insight you get it from the scatter plot. Yes, Kavi says that, right. It summarizes saying that men are elder than women on an average, to be precise. So the problem with summary stats when you summarize an entire data is you tend to lose the information meaning, you tend to lose the insight sometimes. Yeah. That's what exactly Kavi comes up with the statement saying, hey, husband's wages are ages are increasing proportionally. Of course, here we are taking individual camp, individual couples, and we are not looking at a time horizon here. So we cannot say increasing proportionally, but we can still say husbands and wives' ages are correlated, let's say, over the generations, because if you are having a husband and a wife couple here, these guys probably have married, let's say, 40 years ago. If you have a husband and couple here, I mean, all this data is taken at a single point of time. These guys married just 5 years ago or something. So what we can say is that the relation between husband and wife age existed for good so many years. I mean, the relationship between their ages, let's say. Huh? Exactly. Linear relationship, right? So what is this called, guys? This is called a correlation. I'll explain you in detail. But by the way, this is the same data for which I have done summary statistics. But you cannot figure out the insight in scatter plot from here. You cannot decide the insight in scatter plot also from here, even if you look at a sample. That is the beauty of the visualization. So either the descriptive stats, which talks about a sample, we kept two samples here. Inferential, this is inferential more. Sample, and talking about a population. This is descriptive, right? They both fail in understanding a relationship between two variables, whereas a scatter plot is able to do it. But a scatter plot is understood by human brain. How do you make a computer understand a scatter plot or a relation? Like just like Ankit says, hey, Prithvi, there is a relationship. Yeah, how do we calculate that relationship? How do a computer make sense out of it? So there comes that variable correlation. Relation between, exactly, calculate correlation. So the correlation is nothing but it tries to map a relation between two husbands and wife, husbands and wife's ages. Or for that example, any two random variables, we can see how much they are correlated, whether there is a relation or not. Correlate. Even before we get to correlate, we have to talk about first covariance. Correlate is more of a verb which is more common, but there is a term called correlation also. Before that, we'll study covariance first of all. So the formula of covariance is nothing but sigma of x minus x bar into y minus y bar divided by n minus 1. What's x bar comma y bar? They're the mean of x comma y. And what I'm trying to do in the covariance is like, right? I'm trying to take point by point x and y. See how x is away from the mean and see how y is away from the mean and try to multiply the differences. All right? So a point is, let's say I draw here x, I draw here y. For convenience, we take two means, right? So you have here, let's say x1, x2, x3. These are nothing but 3 points. And here, let's say y1, this will be y2, and I'll be putting at a more farther distance y3. So what the covariance talks about it, take the difference between, of course, the mean is here x2. Let me put x bar is equal to x2, y bar is equal to y2. We are trying to see this difference and we are trying to take this difference and multiply both of them. That will become our first term. Plus, what is the second term? It's nothing but x sigma over all terms. So x2 minus x2, it will become 0. And the third term is, again, how much x3 is away from the mean? How much y3 away from the mean, y2? Again, take, okay, let me put here. Again, take this differences and multiply. And the multiplication will, if I have to write it in the formula perspective, I will have to write it x1 minus x2 into y1 minus y2 plus x2 minus x2 into y2 minus y2 because our mean is x2 and y2 plus x3 minus y2, sorry, x2 into y3 minus y2 and a whole divided by n minus 1. Again, degrees of freedom has come into picture. It's not n, it's n minus 1. Getting it how covariance is calculated. Now, what this gives us? This gives us, if x is changing, how much y is changing? Because point to point, we are trying to see the differences. If x1 moves a bit, how much y1 moves? That is what covariance will try to give you. On an average, we are looking at the separation itself. What is the relative point of separation we take is mean. I just explained the formula in detail. If you don't understand, just remember this. And covariance gives us strength of how much each variables are related. Clear? Now, if covariance is positive, then both are on same side. If both are on opposite side, covariance is negative. That's understood because x minus x1, this is negative, this is negative. The entire covariance will be positive. This is positive, this is positive. Entire covariance will be positive. But either of it is negative and one is positive, then covariance will be negative. This is positive and this is negative. The covariance will be negative. Four possible cases. X, so you have a mean here, x bar. Your x1 is this side. And let's say your y bar, y1 is this side. That means as x moves from x to x bar this side, y moved from y to y bar this side. That means as x is increasing, y is decreasing, or x is decreasing, y is increasing. That kind of relation we wanted to point out. So this makes x1 minus x bar will be negative, y1 minus y bar will be positive, but the covariance will be positive, positive into negative, which will become negative. That's what it indicates. As x increases, y decreases. It's nothing but a proportionality. The relationships, covariance talks about two things here, direction as well as relationship. Covariance is high, then both are strongly related. X and Y are strongly related. covariance is positive, then they both are positively correlated. Covariance is negative, then both are negatively correlated. That means one increases, the other decreases. By the way, covariance is something obtained by variance only. What is Sx square? Sigma of x minus x bar into x minus x bar by n minus 1. Isn't it right? Isn't it the variance formula, guys? What is S y square? Sigma of y minus y bar. Of course, I have to put square, but I'm writing it y minus y bar divided by n minus 1. When you are very good with fundamentals, you'll be able to understand. So covariance, the name itself says that, okay, it's obtained by two variables, Sx square, Xy square. Pick this, put here, pick this, put here, and you get a covariance. Right. Any questions? We'll calculate manually, don't worry. I'll make you calculate. Yep. They have a positive relation, yes. Yes, the covariance indicates the strength of Kavi. The covariance indicates the strength of how we X and Y are correlated. We will calculate it and see it also. Just a moment. I have some numbers taken. X minus X bar, calculate it. Y minus Y bar, calculate it. X minus X bar into X minus X bar, Y minus Y bar. Everything to do it. So here our covariance is sigma of X minus X bar into Y minus Y bar. That makes it 30. 30. Divided by n minus 1. How many n he have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 1, that will become 4. 7.5, let's say. So 7.5 is the covariance. That is nothing but the relationship strength between x and y. Or if x changes by 1, y changes by 7.5 on an average. That we can say. But as Kavi's question is like, what are we doing with covariance here? I'll come to that. Just put the formulas again. There's a problem with covariance because when I said 7.5, it doesn't make any sense to you. What is happening, Prithvi? What is 7.5? Oh, the relationship between X and Y? Okay, fine. How does it make sense to me? Like how to make it understand? So that is the important problem with covariance. It's not standardized. It's just a number. It keeps on changing. For example, we need to compare AB and also we need to compare AC. Right? And we have to tell which is closely related to A, either B or C. So covariance of A comma B is equal to 9 and covariance of A comma C is equal to 28, let's say. Can you tell me, guys, covariance of, so C is closely related to A. Is that a statement? Can you make it? Can you make a statement saying C is closely related to A than B? No, we cannot make that statement because Ankita, I'll come back to your question. Because they're not on same line. Because B might be different on different, B is on different scale, C is on different scale than A. You can't compare. Covariance itself doesn't convey anything special. this was Kavi's answer. It doesn't convey anything special. It just shows a relation. At max, you can say positive or negative. So to make covariance more meaningful, it's standardized into a dimensionless quantity that makes more sense. When you standardize it into dimensionless quality.